Hey, what's up everyone, and once again welcome back to Super Smash Bros. For Nintendo 3DS. Last time we took on All-Star Mode using Palutena right here, and this time we are going to be taking on All-Star with Marth. Now as for the palette, he has some pretty decent ones in this game, I gotta say. There's one, I believe it's this one, that kind of makes him look like his melee colors. And then I really like the gold one, but I think my personal favorite is probably still White Marth, or Wedding Day Marth, so I'm gonna keep up the tradition and go as White Marth. Because, oh, I hit the microphone. I don't know, I just really like this palette swap, I think it looks really clean. And, ooh, look at him standing out! Tip! That was not the tip, but it still did decent damage. Pac-Man, could you not? That'd be great. Take it back! Ooh, Jesus, okay! Okay, Jesus Christ. We just messed Pac-Man up. Shield Breaker does immense amounts of damage on these guys. Well, I guess maybe I've just been getting the tipper off. God, Marth is really fun, honestly. He can be kind of interesting and somewhat difficult to control if you're going for combos, or if you just don't really know him too well, I guess, like me, but he just feels like a fun character to use. Maybe because I've played him so much in Subspace, and he was just a lot of fun there. Luigi, don't hit me with your butt. Just because your new official artwork has your freaking backside sticking out does not mean that gives you the right to hit me with your butt like that. It doesn't. Okay. You know what? Just have a slightly tapped Shield Breaker. Little Mac, you can. Oh no. Oh no. No, you don't. I need to get rid of that, bud. I'm gonna need you to. No! Okay, I thought he hit me with it. I will be honest. I thought he KO punched me, and I was about to freak out. I kind of already did freak out. Okay. All right, Little Mac, you scared me a little, but that's fine. That's fine. Let's move on. Jesus Christ, my heart. I think my heart stopped. Is that how that works? I think that's how that works. My heart literally stopped. All right, here we go. Duck Hunt. We haven't had this stage in a little while, as far as I remember, anyway. I don't know. When you do a lot of these in a row, you kind of don't really remember much. And also, wait, has the score display always been on the bottom of this stage, and I've just never noticed it? I feel like it was like attached to the stage, but no, it's like a part of the HUD right now. Because if we pause, oh wait, how do I do it on this? Yeah, it's not there right here. Oh, that's panning. Okay, it's so strange on 3DS. Yeah, you see down there with the shots left and the duck count and everything. I actually don't remember seeing that like that before. I guess I'm just noticing it now. I don't know what it is, but okay. Yeah. No, you don't, sir. No, he's already gone. All right, Zelda and Link, get out of here. You're not recovering. Get out. Okay, never mind. They're recovering. Stop it. Get out of here, Link. Samus, don't you come up to me. Don't you test me. I got this. Oh my god, Link is still just chilling. You can have a shield wrong way. Come here, Link. Boom. Tipped, fully charged Shield Breaker. I will take it. I'll be honest, I don't get many opportunities to A, connect with the Shield Breaker, or even more so, B, connect with the Shield Breaker on a shield. So that's going to be my goal this time around. I want to actually break a shield using the Shield Breaker, because it's called the Shield Breaker, so it would make sense that you would break shields with it, no? I think it would. Oh, okay, so we got the Reset Bomb Forest stage. We were kind of discussing or mentioning this one in the last episode since we played as Palutena in the Viridi palette. We might actually get to see Viridi. In fact, most likely we will get to see Viridi, because I tend to spend a lot of time on this stage, because this fight just takes a while for some reason. Yeah. Ryu, did you shield that? You don't have those new perfect shield mechanics yet. You don't get to do that. Okay, Palutena avoided that. Right up into the Metal Blade. Alright, Viridi, are you coming? I want to see you, Viridi. You're my favorite. You're great. I want to see you. Alright, Ryu, you need to get out of here. There we go. Can I shield break? I feel like these guys never shield, so it's probably not going to happen, but... Nope. Oh, there she is. There's my girl Viridi in the back. Okay, hold on. Doc is the only one not on high damage. There goes Marth. That was not Marth, that was Mega Man. Oh god, that's like in an episode of Pokemon Ranger. I don't know if it's out yet. It's actually the finale, so I probably shouldn't spoil this, but yeah, whatever. In an upcoming, or possibly released at this point, episode of Pokemon Ranger, I accidentally call a Pokemon by the wrong name. Like, completely the wrong name. That's not really a spoiler if I just say it like that. And I put like the little JonTron what up on the screen, and I'm proud of that. I don't know why. I just thought of that in the moment. I was like, why did I call this Pokemon that Pokemon? They look nothing alike. And I was just like, this needs a reaction, but not something that intrudes too much on the video. And I went quiet after saying it anyway, so there you go. And that's why that's in there. It's a good meme. It's a good, nice little meme to throw in the video. Alright, got the blue Pikmin trophy from beforehand, of course. I keep looking at my desktop wallpaper of the new official Smash art, and actually, you know what? I should pick up this boy. And I've said it before, I said this on Twitter. One, it looks like Samus is about to dunk Zelda on this full artwork page. I don't know why. And also, it looks like Young Link is about to chop off Ryu's legs. So, they really went all out with this artwork. If you haven't seen it, I believe it is on the official Smash Bros. Website, smashbros.com. And I definitely recommend you check it out. It's got all of the characters on it. It spans three monitors if you put it as your desktop wallpaper. It's pretty fantastic, and I can't even see the left-hand side of it because my third monitor is my TV and it's not on right now. Because I don't really use it all that often as a monitor, it's just always connected. So, I don't know, it's some fantastic artwork, and I love that they also used the same art style for the... or that they're gonna be using the same art style for the box art. Like, instead of just using in-game assets, I love when companies do that. When the actual box art of the game is not just ripped from within the game and it's like custom made. Smash Ultimate is a wonderful example of that. And also, we are messing this Meta Knight up. This is not Subspace. Get out of here. We're not on the same team. Although I guess they do fight at the beginning of that one cutscene, but still. Also on this artwork, it just looks like Captain Falcon is just kind of floating there. He's doing his, show me your moves, but he's like in the air. And it just looks really odd. Alright, so we have three fights left, I believe. You know what? I'm gonna take this. Because the last time we came through, we actually only took 2% damage on one of the fights. And didn't even need the last heart container. So I don't really want to have to risk... Oh god. And it's Spirit Train. So I actually don't feel bad about taking the heart container at all. Because we got Spirit Train. So... You know, sometimes I do wish that All-Star Mode was treated like it was in Melee, and I believe in Brawl, where if you die, you don't restart from the beginning, you just restart from where you were, but have to spend a bunch of coins, and essentially lose, like, all of your points. I kind of would be fine with them doing it that way, purely for the series, but I guess I see why they did it the other way, and why they made it so that you restart the whole thing. Well, actually, you know what? No, I don't. Why would they do that? If they do it that way in Ultimate with 70 plus characters, that's just gonna be kind of a pain if you have to restart the whole thing. Because imagine you die on the last fight. Okay, could you stop it? I'm definitely glad that I took the heart container now. God, this stage is a pain. This stage is a pain in All-Star Mode. Get out of here, Pikachu. We've killed like nobody so far. How did you two survive? Pikachu's still, he's coming back. He's recovering from that. Come here, Pika. Come on up. Bye-bye. Okay, we gotta get rid of Cloud, like, immediately, because we're already on decently high damage. And I don't trust him! I don't want him to get Limit. Oh, he got Limit. Probably because I hit him so much and didn't kill him. There goes Sheik, almost. Not really. Alright, you need to not come over here. Mr. Cloud Strife! Get out of here! He's the scariest character, I swear. Him and Little Mac, especially when you get up to high damage in All-Star Mode, are just... Not the guys you want to be around. Alright, 1v1 me, Ganondorf. Come here, 1v1 me. 1v1 me, bro. Come here. 1v1 me, bro, come here. Come here. Got him. Oh, it's satisfying. Although it's not as satisfying as the actual... who is it? There's one professional Smash player who has like a Marth combo named after him. I don't remember who it is, though. But it's where you do like a bunch of forward aerials followed by a down aerial and just dunk everybody. Alright, so definitely taking this. This could be risky. If we get to the last character and we're on like decently high damage, I'll attempt to take enough damage to get us up to 100, but... just so we can heal. Also, this is a much better stage to get. I'm A-okay with getting Distant Planet. I'll tell you what, anything above 50% by the end of the fight, and I'll take enough damage so that we can heal using the Fairy Bottle. How's that sound? Oh god. I don't know how I avoided that first hit, but I'll take it. Anything under 50%, I'm not going to attempt to heal after this, because I think we can manage in the last fight. I mean, I might regret saying that, and I might regret that decision, but... I mean, hey, so far, Roy's being a freaking idiot. Can I just stab him in the head? There we go. Zero suits. Get off the top. Nice! Like, just like three hits on Zero Suit and she was gone. Roy, you've been here since like the beginning of the fight. Could you leave? Thank you. Now, Ike's here. Yeah, you hit that pallet, Toon Link. You don't need to, you don't really need to do that. Give that to the Pikmin. Let him turn that in for some new reinforcements. Get out of here, Lucas! Oh god. Come here. Someone come down here and let me hit you. Alright, Ike. Oh, Lucario! You, sir, just ruined my zero damage run. I wasn't pointing it out because I thought I was going to be able to pull it off and I would have been really proud of myself. But no, you had to go and screw it up for me, didn't you? God damn it, Lucario. Could you leave? Could you just leave? Get out of here. Buddy, don't you throw that pellet at me. I'm throwing a pellet at you. I'll throw this five pellet at you. Like that. There we go. He ruined it. We totally could have done that with zero damage if Lucario didn't use his freaking side B on me. That's fine, I guess. That is fine, I guess. Alright, so we're not healing, because we don't need to, and also we can't. Moving to the final fight. Let's see how we do. Also, this has been the first episode in a while where I've kind of just discussed the game and not talked about random stuff, I feel like. God, I love this music. X and Y had some fantastic music. I gotta say. Could you not do 2% damage to me? That'd be great, Rosalina. There goes Wii Fit. Freaking garbage character. I don't know. I don't really like Wii Fit all that much. Not the games. Well, I don't really like the games either, but... Wii Fit Trainer as a character, I just never got the hang of controlling, and I don't really know why, but... Did she just, like, let out a huge gasp? Did Rosalina just, like, gasp as she was about to die? Because that's actually really cool. I've never heard that before. Alright, we're actually doing really decent as Marth here. That platform saved my ass. Alright, Lucina's out. You're dead! And... Oh, hello, Greninja. That was an unfortunate place to spawn. I don't think we're gonna get a shield breaker off. But you know what we're gonna do? We're gonna make it so that Greninja's the last one for a change and not Karin. How's that sound? Because I am sick of fighting Karin as the last guy. You don't need to be... Whoa. You don't need to be the last guy every time, Karin. Get out of here. Greninja, move! Ah! Karin? I swear to God, Karin, you need to get out of here. I'm trying to keep you alive, Greninja. Don't come and hit me. Don't tempt me, Greninja. Karin, my dude. Are you gone? You're not gone. Jump up. Boom! Alright, Karin's gone. Greninja, bring it on in, buddy. Bring it in. Let me hit you with the Dancing Blade. Okay. Ooh, Dancing Blade is really satisfying to hit with if you connect all four hits. And there we go. For ow, my thumb. Another run in the bag. We got a light suit, apparently, and that was the quickest one we've had in, like, the last three or four episodes, so I will take it. If anyone knows of anyone out there who makes custom amiibo of the alternate character trophies, please let me know, because there's some of these poses and costumes that I would love to have as their own amiibo. And honestly, I don't know why Nintendo didn't do it. They did it for certain characters, meaning they did it for the last three DLC characters. Sometimes I feel like they did that just because it took them so long to actually release those amiibo. They were like, we've been messing around with this for a while. Here, take amiibo of their alts. Because they didn't give Robin an alt amiibo. They did it for Karin, Cloud, and Bayonetta, but they didn't do it for Robin. They didn't do it for Bowser Jr. They didn't do it for Olimar with Alf. They didn't do it for anyone else except those last three, which kind of confuses me to this day. Like, why did they do that? Maybe they just wanted to make money off of the last three characters because it had been so long. You know what? That's probably the exact reason why. But hey, what can you do? I don't make amiibo. Speaking of amiibo, though, I think I mentioned about the new Smash ones being Inkling and Ridley. I can definitely see them doing them for all of the returning characters. I believe a Daisy one has been confirmed as well. I don't think we'll get a new Smash line, but if we do, I will definitely be collecting them all, because I'm a crazy person. But, yeah, I was going to say there's been some new amiibo announced as of late. I believe there was a three-pack Octoling amiibo three-pack thingy, which actually interests me, because I've yet to play the Octo expansion for Splatoon 2, and I want to. It just costs money that I can't afford to spend on video games right now. So, I'll get to that when I get to it, but I've seen videos on it. It looks really cool. And I really like the design of the amiibo, so, of all three of the amiibo, so I will most likely pick those up, probably not on launch, but there we go. But I've definitely left space on my amiibo display for them. I'm gonna have to reorganize the whole thing once the rest of the Smash ones get announced, because we're definitely getting them for all the newcomers, and most likely all the returning veterans who did not get amiibo. So, you know, a Snake amiibo, a Pichu amiibo, Young Link, Ice Climbers, Ivysaur, Pokemon Trainer, Squirtle. I don't know how they're gonna do those guys, but whatever! Sometimes I talk too much and almost miss the cue to shut up so we can have the music go louder, but anyway, I was gonna say, you know, all the returning characters, I definitely feel like they're gonna get amiibo. I want a wolf amiibo, I want a snake amiibo. It's gonna be a great time. I'm excited. You know, I'm real excited for the future of video games. I just love video games, man. I freaking love video games. How have I only played through, what, 56 video games for this channel? I need to do more. Alright, so here we go with Marth's customs. We have Storm Thrust. Thrust your sword forward, creating a gust of wind that knocks opponents back. We have Effortless Blade. You can't change the combo type, but you can wait longer between attacks for lower damage. We have Crescent Slash. Rise in an arc while attacking. Deals most damage at the midpoint and doesn't go as high. And we have Easy Counter. Your counter stance lasts longer, but the attack power is lower. I feel like that's kinda useless. Because if it stays out longer, people are going to see it and not attack you. Alright, Storm Thrust. That pushed Sandbag forward, alright. Or backward. Does it send us back? It does not. God, that's so dissatisfying. Alright, Effortless Blade. It's... yeah, you can't change the combo type like it said. Let me get you back over there, please, sir. No, over there, sir. Over there, sir. You know what? I've got this. Okay. Let's see, so... you can't wait too much longer, but you can wait a little bit longer. Crescent Slash, that's weird. That sends you... why, you like disappear for a frame. I'm not sure I like that one. And then Easy Counter, look how long that stays out. People are gonna notice that. And obviously it does less damage, but people are gonna notice that. That's not... I feel like that's not ideal. Like, why would you play with that? But then again, people don't really play with customs, so... oh well. Alright, heading into the vault, we are gonna take a look at our alternate Marth trophy, which of course uses, I believe, the gold palette swap. There he is, my boy. Marth's side special Dancing Blade is a four-stage attack. Aim and time your strikes carefully. The tip of his sword does the most damage. For his up smash Justice Sword, he thrusts his blade into the air. You can use it to block attacks from above and launch nearby foes. And he's of course doing his counter pose right here. Which is real nice looking. I like Marth quite a bit. He's been around since Melee, and he's not going anywhere. Alright, folks, that is going to go ahead and do it for this episode of Super Smash Bros. For Nintendo 3DS. Next time, we are taking on All-Star Mode using my boy, Ike. So, if you guys enjoyed this video, please make sure to leave a like and let me know what you thought of it in the comment section below. Stay tuned for the next one, and I'll see you guys then.